Thank you everyone for coming today for the fourth edition of Cannabis Startup Europe. The goal of this meetup is first of all to learn about a specific topic about cannabis, to connect with great people and to create together in order to develop this beautiful industry. So thank you again for coming tonight, and we hope to see you again for our next event. It's very important to have people getting together, talking, creating. It's exactly what we need into the cannabis industry, is smart people getting together and creating beautiful things. So today the topic of the day is CBD. CBD, a compound coming from hemp, a compound which has been discussed more and more over a few years, and it's a really great topic because it's also the basic of our products. So first of all, a little reminder of what is cannabis. I'm sure most of you know about this, but cannabis is a plant which contains more than 400 compounds. Only one makes you high, is THC. So then you have another 100 of compounds which doesn't make you high and which can be used in a lot of different ways. So everyone has been super focused on THC and when they think about cannabis. And this kind of event is also a way to break the cliché. We are not going to talk about THC, even if we love THC as well, but that's not the point of the meetup today. So cannabis is one plant which have many strains, and to make it easier to understand, we define two main families of cannabis. The first one is marijuana, which will contain a high dose of THC and which will be used for recreational usage to get high most of the time. You have also medical marijuana, but that's not the topic of the day. And then in the second big family is hemp. So how we define hemp? Hemp is cannabis which contains less than 0.2% THC. So you don't get high with hemp. However, in some strain of hemp, you have different strain in the hemp family, you have most of the time some CBD from 0.5% up to 5% depending on the strains, depending on who you grow hemp. And this CBD, also called cannabidiol, is a very interesting compound because first of all, it's totally safe to use. There is absolutely no relevant side effect. It's no psychotropic, so you don't get high from it. It's non-toxic, so you cannot die from CBD. You can intake kilos of CBD and it's maybe going to make you sleepy, but you're not going to overdose. So it's a very safe compound which can be used in many different ways. So CBD is this compound from cannabis. First of all, I want to come back to this image just to show you what is this. It's cannabis in Zoom, and what you can see here is like some little stuff here that we call the trichome, and it's into that you have the cannabinoid and you have the CBD. So how to extract CBD, how to get CBD only or an extract with mostly CBD and nothing else, is by extracting the trichome. You have different ways to extract CBD. The first one is, this is the main three ways of extracting CBD today. So the main one is using a gas called butane or dexo. You put it with pressure with the hemp plant material or cannabis hemp material, and then you can get some resin. You can also use ethanol to extract the CBD, and you get this yellow resin when it's very pure. Then you have another type of extraction, which is called CO2 extraction, CO2 supercritic extraction. So in this type of extraction, we are going to use hair, with high pressure, And this will break the trichome, and depending on the pressure and the standard you use, and then you can get an extract which will contain mainly CBD. So CO2, supercritical extraction, is a kind of extraction very used, for example, in the cosmetic industry to extract some flavor, and is something which is very efficient. So for us, it's very interesting to use CO2 extraction because we have to process a lot of hemp in order to get CBD. So we work with some laboratories which are very big machines of CO2 extraction, which they extract different type of plant or flower to get the flavors, and in our case with hemp to get the CBD. And then you have the molecular separation. So this is the last type of extraction, is if you want to have pure CBD. So pure CBD, by the name talk by itself, but it's like just the compound CBD, usually pure at 99%, so it's a white powder. And to get this, you need to do a molecular separation, so really you get rid of everything else except it's CBD, and you got pure CBD. So usually the molecular separation is the last step after a supercritical CO2 extraction. What's the usage of CBD today? The usage of CBD will totally depend on the concentration of CBD and the system of deliverability. Depending on the dosage and depending how you're going to take your CBD, it will define the usage, the benefits of CBD. So today, CBD can be used in a very wide range of applications, and it will really depend on what dosage of CBD you're going to take and how you are going to deliver it, if it's inhaling it, ingesting it, or on the skin. And CBD is backed by science. Science, medical cannabis science, has been super limited because of the prohibition of cannabis. And unfortunately, the research about CBD has been also super limited because of the limitation on cannabis. So researchers always had a very hard time to study compounds from cannabis because of the prohibition. However, the past few years, past 10, 15 years, we had more and more scientists looking into CBD and the potential effect on CBD on many, many conditions. And today, we define CBD usage based on the daily dose you want to intake. And some studies define now two kind of dose. The high dose, which we consider an high dose, is something which is over 200 milligrams of CBD by day. And this has real therapeutic purposes, is for medical usage. And it has been shown to be efficient and have very great potential on many conditions like epilepsy, diabetes, cancer, Alzheimer. So a lot of research still has to be done. We are just at the very beginning of the medical usage of CBD, but at high dose there are already some medical studies showing a very big potential to treat very serious conditions. After, at a medium dose that we define between 20 to 200 milligrams of CBD by day, we'll talk more about health maintaining properties. And we will look at CBD for antioxidative, neuroprotective, anti-inflammatory effects. So that's the dosage you can get, for example, from food supplements, and will help you to maintain your health. So it's not a very medical usage, but still it's an usage which is different, and we will go in more details a bit later. So right now, what's the biggest issue with CBD is the legal framework we live in. Because obviously CBD has been is compound coming from hemp, coming from cannabis. Cannabis is prohibited. So the legislation today is very unclear in Europe, and that's what we need very urgently, a proper legislation for CBD in Europe. Because today, CBD is more and more used by people. There is a booming demand because people look online, they hear about it, and they want to try because they know it can work for their condition. The problem is because the regulations are not very clear, you don't have a lot of offer. So some companies will start to make CBD products because there is a demand and there is a very low offer. Unfortunately, because of the lack of regulation, there is no much quality control. So you end up on the market with very bad products which are not safe to be used, which doesn't contain the right amount of CBD. Because today there is no strong regulation, and because of this, there is no big companies investing a lot on CBD, because it's very tricky to invest into a compound if you're not sure of the return of investment you can have. And if you invest into making a product very right, you need to invest millions into a production process, into making a new product, validating the effect on the product. It costs a lot. And if you're not sure, and if maybe the law will change one day and block your product because of the evolution of the law, it's very unsafe. So that's the situation we are today. CBD is being used by more and more people for many different applications. However, there is no real offer, you know, from serious companies because of the unclarity of the regulations. And the type of CBD product that you can find today and the type of CBD product that you will find into the future, we define it in three different categories, and it's always depending on the dosage. So the first category of product is real medicinal products, which you can get with or without a prescription, but usually it will be recommended by a doctor, so it's for very high dosage of CBD. If you have a serious medical condition, you want to treat, you want to cure. Then you have a second category of product, which will be more the food supplement category or herbal products you can find in pharmacies or in convenience stores, and you don't need any prescription. You buy it to maintain your health, and this concerns the medium dosage in CBD. And then you have a last category, which is the food and cosmetic category, where you have a low dosage of CBD, but still it's a very, very great usage, even if there is a low dosage, and can help and reply to the needs of a lot of people. Even a low dosage of CBD can be very efficient. And this is the type of CBD products you will find today on the market. Unfortunately, there are not yet regulations about it. So it's a bit of a mix. Some people will sell some products with very low dosage of CBD, saying it can cure or treat some medical condition, where we know that to treat some medical condition, you need a very high dosage. So there is a lot of confusion on the market because of the lack of regulation. And that's why what we try to push is really to define different type of products, different type of distribution network, depending on the dosage of CBD. Now let me talk quickly about CBD liquids, because that's exactly what we do at Harmony for a couple of years. So what is an e-liquid? An e-liquid is something you will put into a vaporizer or an electronic cigarette, and then you're going to vape. So it's an inhalation of CBD. And why CBD liquids is very useful? First of all, it's because you will offer a way for people which are smokers of cannabis, for example, to switch to vaporization. And we know that smoking cannabis, smoking cigarette, you do a combustion of tobacco or for cannabis, and it's not good for your lungs. So that's why actually electronic cigarette has been more and more developed, and vaporizing as well, because vaporizing is way better than combustion, than smoking. So for cannabis users, CBD liquid helps them to control their usage. Instead of smoking weed, they have for the first time a legal alternative if they want to reduce the amount of spliff they're going to smoke every day. Some people smoke spliff every day and they feel good about it. Some other people will get stuck a bit and smoke too much, you know, and they don't have any help, you know, except the authorities telling them, it's not good what you do. But then on the market, there is no no products to help them to better control their usage of cannabis. And CBD liquid is exactly made for that. It's made for people which want to better control their usage and switch from combustion, which is bad, not very good, to vaporization. Also, CBD liquid is kind of a liquid quite unique into the market of electronic cigarettes, because right now in the electronic cigarettes you have most of the time an e-liquid with nicotine, because an electronic cigarette is a risk reduction tool for people smoking cigarettes initially. They use electronic cigarettes and an e-liquid with nicotine, so they can stop to have this combustion, they vaporize and can better control their usage. However, nicotine is extremely toxic. It's a compound which is super toxic, and for example, if you drink some pure nicotine, you're gonna die. So it's not a super compound to use. Also, nicotine for liquid usually it's coming from China or India, so there is no control on traceability on where the nicotine is coming from today. Still, it's a product which you can find in any shop today, and still the authorities let this product being distributed. Why? It's because it's a good risk reduction tool. People smoking cigarettes switch to liquid with nicotine, an electronic cigarette, and like that they can have a tool which is less risky to use than smoking cigarette, and they can over months, over years, quit actually smoking cigarettes. And that's why we really push for a wide distribution of our CBD liquid into convenience store, because we think it's a very great risk reduction tool, and to accelerate and to facilitate the adoption from smokers. Obviously, they have to find the product the same in an easy way. So CBD liquid doesn't contain a very high dosage of CBD. It's actually quite low for each puff, but it's really helpful for people smoking cannabis and wants like a kind of like a healthier way to get some cannabinoids into their body. And now I wanted to focus on the difference between pure CBD and CBD extract. So pure CBD, as I told you before, is the compound which is pure most of the time at 99% so or more. So you are going to get only the CBD content, which is great because you don't have any trace of THC into the product. There is no authority which can tell you, hey, your product is illegal, there is 0.1% THC. Because the thing is, THC, obviously, it's a controlled substance. So in the law, if you have even a little THC, it can be considered as a controlled substance and illegal, where CBD is not a controlled substance. So you can, for now, use CBD in your products, and it's legal. Then you have another type of CBD, which is available on the market, another type of CBD products. Is CBD made from extract. So what is the difference? Actually, pure CBD is coming from a CBD extract, just it's been purified. In a CBD extract, what do you have? You have mostly CBD, but you have also some other compound coming from the hemp, like for example the terpene, which give the taste and the flavors. And you will have also some other cannabinoids in a very, very low dosage. And you will have also a bit of THC. So 0.1, 0.2, 0.5%. So it doesn't gonna get you high. However, there is trace of THC. So some authorities can stop the product and say, hey, it's legal, there is THC. So right now, CBD extract is been used in Europe, and a lot of people are selling actually products made from CBD extract. And don't have any issue with authorities. This is a kind of tolerance. It can change in the future. However, CBD extract is interesting to use because, first of all, it's easier to get because doing pure CBD requires molecular separation, which is quite a complex and costly process. And also in CBD extract, you will get the full profile of cannabinoids. Even if you have a very small amount of the other cannabinoids, still they are there. So it creates what we call an entourage effect. It means that all the cannabinoids, even at very low dosage, can work together to improve the effect of CBD and the effect of the product on the condition you try to improve. So I would say that CBD extract and products made from CBD extract is actually a bit better than products made just with pure CBD. However, legally, it's a bit challenging as well to use CBD extract today when you want to develop a sustainable company and really conform with the law. Why CBD is not more used? And that's a very important question, because everyone hears about CBD, and I'm saying CBD is awesome and you can do many things with CBD. So you could think why nobody, or why more people, more companies are not using CBD, because if it's so good, maybe some big companies will use it. The reason actually is because cannabis has been prohibited and diabolized for so long that today everything coming from cannabis, even if it's not THC, which makes you high, will have a bad image. So for a big company to use a compound from cannabis, it's taking a risk on their image, and they don't want to take this risk because they are big companies, so they don't want to piss off their clients, which will be against cannabis. Also, big companies are afraid also because of the regulations, as I was saying earlier. The regulations on cannabinoids and CBD is not very solid yet. So they are a bit afraid to take a risk because it can impact the rest of their activity. So as a startup, that's a great opportunity for us, because we're not afraid of taking risks. That's the basic of a startup, is to take smart risks to be able to grow and disrupt these big companies, which are too afraid to use this this amazing compound. To finish, I wanted to explain you a bit what is the CBD industry today. So that's the main activity you can do if you want to get into CBD business. So first of all, everything starts by the plant. So everything starts by the hemp farmers, which grow hemp. Hemp is a plant grown for thousands of years in Europe. It's very easy to grow. It grows very well, doesn't need a lot of water. So it's quite actually easy to grow hemp, because there is not a lot of regulations. If you use one of the hemp strains certified in Europe, you don't need many papers to do it. You don't need many authorization. Just need to notify your local authority about it and get some certified seeds. Also, it's low technology, so it's easy to start, because you just need seeds. You just need a farm and a bit of water and sun, and it's beautiful. It's growing. Then, once you have this plant material, to get some CBD, you need to extract it. So you will work with some extraction laboratories. And again, like for extracting hemp, is not a very complicated regulations, because you're still on an industrial level. So you need a license, but it's not like you're making a product for the end users. So that's why I put it on the left, more on no regulations. However, it's kind of high technology, because if you want to seriously extract hemp, you need big machines to do it, and it costs a lot of money. So it's kind of complicated to put in place. And then from the CBD, you can create some products in different categories. I define them here between the electronic cigarette, the food and cosmetic, and the pharma. So I put the electronic cigarette again on the left, low regulations, because the electronic cigarette is actually a product that you don't need to officially register, at least not, you don't need to get an authorization. You need to notify your product So the framework, legal framework, is actually pretty empty. So there is no obligation or authorizations to have. However, if you work on the food and cosmetic and you create CBD product for the food and cosmetic in the segment or the pharma segment, it's going to become really harder because you are going to need to officially register your product to your local authority. And because they don't know CBD really well yet, it's going to be a bit of an issue. However, the times play for us, the more we move on into the future, the easier it's going to get. But today, to register officially a CBD product, it's still very complicated because also in front of you, you have some big companies which doesn't want you to use CBD because they know CBD is super efficient. And some big companies have actually some copyright and some usage of CBD, but they don't want to use it because it's complicated, as I said before, because of their image and the regulations, and also because it will compete with their product. For example, in the pharmaceutical level, CBD can be used with great efficiency for pain management or for anxiety. So the market of painkiller and the market of anxiolytic is so huge, it will compete directly against this kind of medication. And they spend billions to promote them, to register them, so they are super afraid of this compound, CBD. Because CBD also, it's hard to patent, it's coming from a plant, everyone can grow hemp, extracting it, it's complicated, but not as complicated as creating a new drug into a laboratory, a synthetic drug. So on this segment of food and cosmetic and pharma, it's a bit more complicated to register a product. However, a lot of people now are pushing and lobbying in Europe to be able to register CBD products. So hopefully we can have some very qualitative products into this segment launch very soon, and that's what we are working on also at Harmony. If you want more information about CBD, I will recommend to go on the website of the European Industrial Hemp Association, which is the biggest association in Europe about hemp. They do a very good job of lobbying, and they have been publishing some really great paper about CBD, about the legality of CBD, the effect of CBD. So it's a very very good source of information. And obviously, you can also ask me if you have any question. I would be really happy to help you. So muchas gracias, everyone, and. And some food. Thank you again for coming, and I hope to see you for the next event.
Thank you.
Thank you.